Alright, I have acquired a lobster. Does she also have dementia? That's not unsettling. Oh, fucking egg. I figured it out. Oh, I gotta get eggs. Do I have eggs? Oh, wait, no. Oh, fudge. I didn't mean to do that. You gotta be kidding me. Beautiful long red hair. Yeah, Dana. She went to the desert with some friends. They all followed this man with a long robe and silky hair on. They all called him Jimmy Jim, which always sounded odd to me. Was Jimmy a diminutive of James? Was Jimmy's last name? It just didn't really roll off the tongue. I'd think a cult leader would be better at coming up with names. Dana kept telling me they were looking for some kind of new water. But the water in the cities was too tainted, full of city sweat and bad omens. But they needed to find a better, cleaner source of water in the desert. She kept wanting me to come with them, telling me this new water would heal everything. That their new community would be beautiful. Everyone in harmony with each other, with nature. Well, it didn't take long for everyone to be dehydrated. The well they dug lasted a few weeks and everyone started fighting over the water. I guess I'm just saying that I know you're busy, you've got things to tend to, people to see, places to be. I don't want to be a bother, but I'll just have to be. I've been thinking about a way to repay you for all that running around. I think I've got a pretty good idea, but I need your help with the final touch. I was talking to one of the people on this boat. I'm so bad with names. Well, new names. Can't seem to remember your passengers. Must be all the comings and goings. Well, they were saying sometimes the boat goes through a swarm of fireflies. Their bellies are sometimes filled with fire glow seeds. Look at that. You've already got some fire glow. No need for all that trouble then. Some beautiful, perfectly spicy fire glow. Oh, what the heck, I can't keep this thing for much longer. Do you remember when you first moved into the building? I've been there for years. I sold the house a few months after David died. The kids were heartbroken at first. They were never there. They just wanted their old rooms to stay perfectly intact, I suppose. Oh, back to you. The fridge broke on the first day. Poor thing. Until you were broke and couldn't afford takeout. Do you remember what happened? That's too bad. I made you soup. Much tasty soup. My favorite soup in the whole wide world. It was laksa. It's the first thing I ate when I moved to the big city alone. I had moved here to be closer to my sister. It was quite the trip. It took a few days. When I got here, my neighbor, Aranya, from 32B, invited me to dinner. Neighbors were friendlier back then. She served laksa. I never tried it before, but I instantly fell in love. For a year straight, I must have invited myself to dinner every single week. Hopefully, I didn't overstay my welcome. The family was so nice. In any case, spicy food became my ultimate friendship test. If you can stomach it, then you can stomach me. And you pass with flying colors. I couldn't help you with fridge, but I could keep you fed. My gift to you is Aranya's family recipe. I can't recreate it anymore. Well, that's not true. I just believe that at my age, I've done enough cooking for a lifetime. Time to let someone else take the reins. If you cook a lot, then maybe we can share it. You just have to put fireglow in that delicious powder of grain. Sorry about that, must have slipped my mind. You have to figure it out, I suppose. That laksa, I'm going to remember. Wouldn't that be lovely? My brother's dying over here. We need food. Time was 30 minutes ago. Oh, you took your sweet time. Wait, what's this? There's fish in a lobster roll? Like, he can't eat that. He's allergic. If he's starting to go, we need to eat this. Mickey might eat something that might kill him scalp. He wants something a little more traditional. Not that fancy garbage, you know what? There's this place on Woodbridge. They had an amazing slogan. What was that? Doesn't matter. They had an absolute best fried chicken. Oh gosh. Everybody wants fried chicken. Mickey had an idea. Apparently there's this place called Grey Mist Peaks. It shouldn't be far from here. Mickey thinks you're, well, we both think you're doing a decent job. Listen, we've been asking a lot from you. Consider this our treat. A little camping trip for your efforts. Some recognition for your discretion and affairs. We've never actually been camping, but we would do this as a gift for you. Let's go take a look at some rocks and trees and shit.
I love them.
Bringing their mom wants freaking fried chicken.
Mm-hmm.
That's not it. Oh, I need chicken. Dang it. Oh, this current. Doesn't our current place have it? Pretty sure there's some place I've gotten chicken before. Can't remember. Always makes me think of my dad. He loved preparing food. He's an absolute genius in the kitchen. His meals would always turn out perfectly. But while he was making them, he was angry. He couldn't take his focus away from making food. It was like he was trying to tame the kitchen or something. It was a fight to the death. He would always win. The meal could take him hours to prepare just right. It took him so long. I remember being a kid and when it was ready, I didn't care what food was in front of me. It could have been cereal for all I cared. I just hated watching him make food back then, waiting for hours for a meal I didn't care about. But every time I eat this, it doesn't seem that bad anymore. Well, thanks, Sprout. I think I should organize a big dinner for everybody on board. Not kidding around. Well, not everyone, just a few people maybe. I think I'd bring spirits up. You should invite everyone and ask them what they want for dinner. Say three of your favorite dinner companions, what do you think? The wrong button. Where's that weird old lady? Wait, actually, let me go take care of the boys first. That's more like it. This tastes exactly like that place's. What was the name? Mickey doesn't know either. Still, it really hits the spot. That's what a scout is for. Scouting for good food. Keep them coming. Hopefully we won't have to ask next time. Bro. Copper ingots. There she is. That's what you told me to make. Dessert. I could have sworn the kid ate him earlier. Potato and fat. Do one more copper ingot, you get the game. Mm-hmm. You ask for French fries. Okay. All right. Really? No, it wasn't crazy. Sorry, I had to go put a jacket on. I was freezing. Goopy. Buy all of them. Get it over with. I didn't go anywhere. Still here.
Oh my gosh, I love this kid. Oh my gosh, I didn't know he slept in a puddle. Oh my gosh, it's an actual tank. What on earth? That's adorable. Okay. Excuse me. Oh no. Poor kid. What happens if I just give the kid a regular egg? Build the cellar. I need one more fabric. Thank you. Did she just give me the recipe? Silly thing. Oh wait, I forgot I can go build that cellar while I wait. No, I cannot build a cellar while I wait. We don't need another three, it looks like. Huh.
spider with a little old lady's house, because that's just a hilarious thought. Goodness, feel better. Okay. My dog is giving me a look. That's painful. Okay, I'll wait this one out because it'll be my luck, I'll get in the middle of something. I forgot I went this way. Thank you. It's trying to take orders from the cat.
It's a little bit of myself. Did you know that? I want to let you in on a little secret. You might love to run around and help all these people, but you need to take some time for yourself. Do something that's only for you. That's something I never got to do myself. I suppose that's why I'm here. In this world, on this boat. That's why Viv and my daughters don't have me around anymore. Well, at least we got each other's route. Damn, that hurts. Oh, he invited the kid. Okay, that's cute. What's that ding? Come sit on my lap, buddy. Hang on. Why don't you come sit on my lap, baby? There you are. So boring, I almost slept the whole time. I guess I'm gonna turn it around. I wanna do a play, theater play for everyone aboard. A story I wanna tell, it's gonna be great. So, you're gonna invite your favorite friends, you can decide how many people you want, find the best audience for my great play. You can play here? Sure, I'll be there. No, thank you. We'll see if we have time. Okay, I've got a great idea. Unless you found some volunteers, we just have to find a place for them. Let's take that big city, Oxbury.
those lights on those buildings would be awesome. Let's go there first, actually, to take care of the kid. Until his dinner party can wait. Get very far. Thank you. What is this? You have to have something. I'm not telling you what it is. It's a surprise. Come find me later. I might have something for you. Alright. I'm so excited, it's gonna be the best. Are you ready to watch my play? Yes, it's ready. There's a girl with a big hat. She's tall, she runs around everywhere. Oh my gosh, so cute. She does everything. There's this big gate, it's huge, it's shiny. Nice to be where that girl lives, because when you're ready, she takes you, then you leave it there, it's long. Everyone else is sad, then boom, big lights, and a big rumble. Explosion, wind, dust, smoke everywhere, everything's quiet for a second. And we don't get to see our friend again. That's when the real pain starts. Yeah, thank you for coming. Oh, that hurts. That's so sad.
Mm-hmm.
Kid. I'm gonna end this episode here and I'll continue in the next one. Good night, guys.